With the help of Ohm's law, we have come to know a very beautiful relation between potential difference and electric current. We got to know about the ratio of these two quantities, which is known as resistance. We have also seen what effect resistance has on the circuit. Every object has its own resistance. But the question is, what are those factors on which resistance depends majorly? In today's video, we will see which factors the resistance depends, and also we will enlighten the different ways of connecting resistance in the circuit. So come on, let's perform an activity to understand. To perform this activity, we need 3 pieces of nichrome wire having lengths of 1/2 meter, 1 meter and 2 meter. Other wire can be taken if there is no nichrome wire. One piece 1/2 meter longer and thicker than the former nichrome wire, an ammeter, a key, a 9-volt battery and wires to connect the circuit. Connect the circuit in this way. As soon as we close the key after connecting the 1/2 meter wire in the circuit, we'll get a reading in the ammeter and write in the table. We know that the connecting wires in the circuit would also have some resistance which can cause in the drop of voltage. But to understand the theory here, the drop in the voltage is not taken into consideration. For this reason, the potential difference that the battery is producing is taken into account only. Now let's replace this with 1 meter wire. What? A change in the reading of the ammeter can be seen. Let us now apply 2 meter wire. The reading changed again. If you look carefully, you will find that by increasing the length of the wire, the value of electric current is decreasing. But the potential difference is constant. This means that the resistance in the circuit is increasing. If the value of the resistance is determined, a pattern will appear. Increasing the length of the wire also increases the resistance. Due to the increase in the length, the electric current has to flow to the larger distance, due to which more resistance is faced by it. This is the reason that the resistance has increased and the value of electric current has decreased. In the second case, we put a thick wire and will compare the reading of the ammeter with the previous case. We saw that there is an increase in the value of the ammeter. If you look closely, you will know that as the thickness of the wire is increased, the current flow has also increased and the resistance has decreased. In other words, the thicker the wire is, the more cross-sectional area the wire has. We can conclude this from the activity. 1. Resistance of wire is directly proportional to the length of the wire. 2. Resistance is inversely proportional to the cross-sectional area of the wire. 3. Also, it depends on the material of the wire, which we have already understood in our last video. It can be written in a mathematical way. If L represents the length of the wire and A is the area of the cross section, then the resistance will be directly proportional to the length and inversely proportional to the area. A constant has to be brought to remove the sign of proportionality. Here, this constant is represented by rho. Rho is known as resistivity. The SI unit of resistivity is the ohm meter. Resistivity depends on the material of the conductor. So this is all about the resistance and the resistivity. Now let's move forward. If we see in our house, different devices are connected to the power supply. You must have noticed that when one device gets defected, then it doesn't have any effect on the other. If one bulb in our house gets fused, then the other one still glows. Or you might have seen a device like a fuse or MCB, which is located near the electric meter. The work of these devices is to minimize the risk of getting the electric appliances defected when there is a short circuit in the house. In this part of the video, we'll learn about connecting these devices in the electric circuit and understand how different resistors are connected in the circuit. You must have heard about the series and parallel many times. What do this series and parallel denote? Let us understand this closely. Let's take a circuit. If an ammeter is placed in the circuit and the switch is turned on, then we will get the value of electric current in the circuit. If one more bulb is added in series here, then the way the first bulb was glowing earlier is not glowing in that way, but both the bulbs are glowing equally lesser than the former case. Hence, the value of the electric current has also decreased. But the same current is flowing in both of the bulbs. Then why are these bulbs are glowing lower now? The reason behind the low brightness of the bulb is due to the change in second quantity of the electricity, that is potential difference. Let us use a multimeter to measure the potential difference. A multimeter is a device used to find the value of many electrical quantities. Here this multimeter will act as voltmeter. If we put the multimeter at these points, we will get 9 volt. And if we connect it with both the bulbs, the reading will look something like this. From this activity, it can be concluded the value of electric current in the series circuit is equal and the value of the potential difference is divided among the resistors based on the resistances in the circuit. The second conclusion is that if the potential difference across each resistance is added, then it will be equal to the total potential difference in the circuit. We can write this conclusion in the form of mathematical formula. And if we apply the Ohm's law here, then we get this kind of equation. We know that current is constant throughout. Lastly, we get the following equation. It can be said that in series connection, if all the individual resistances are added, then we get the equivalent resistance in the circuit. In the second case, if both the bulbs are connected parallelly in the circuit, then the connection is known as parallel circuit. The parallel circuit is opposite to the series. See here, both the bulbs are glowing equally, which means that both the bulbs have an equal amount of potential difference across their ends. At the same time, the electric current appears to be divided in two arms. If you look closely, the entire electric current has increased in this case, even if the battery used is the same. So it can be concluded that the potential difference across the resistance in parallel is equal, but the current is divided in the circuit. If the number of resistance increases, then the current is also divided based on the number of resistances. Here, if we add the values of the individual currents, then we see it will be equal to the equivalent current in the circuit. Here, the equation can be written in this form by applying Ohm's law. As the potential difference is same across the circuit, we get the relation among the resistances of the parallel circuit. If the number of resistors is increased, they will continue to be added in the equation in the same fashion. This is the reason that all the electrical appliances in our house are connected in parallel, so that every appliance can get the current according to their resistance and the malfunction of one appliance will not affect the other. Similarly, the fuses are placed in series so that all the electric current passes through it and at the time of short circuit, no other device gets defected as it stops the electricity supply there only. So in today's video, we found out the factors on which resistance depends. Also the different ways of connecting the resistance in the circuit. Hopefully you have understood everything in this video. At the same time, you must have also understood the secret behind various appliances in the house and how they work. We will get to know about them more closely in the upcoming videos.